right, I'm ready whenever you are. God bless you. Certainly, this is the day that the Lord has made, and we all should be glad and rejoice therein. Certainly, God is a good God, and he's worthy to be praised. God has yet again kept us, and he has not left us in the midst of this crisis. And certainly, we want to bring the word of God to you, even though we cannot congregate together here at the church building. The good news is we are the church. And as I share with everyone, the words still have to get out. And so I wanted to come on and make sure that we still have our word for the week. Certainly, I hope you tuned in to our virtual Bible study on this past Wednesday as we talked about the necessity of prayer. And we do at all times need to pray, whether it's good or bad, especially in these times in which we live. We need to pray. And so thank all of you who joined us for our park and pray. We will do that again this week at 12 noon. We will meet here at the church, and we'll come on the parking lot. We'll park and cut our cars off, and we'll pray unto God, because I believe what the scripture says, that God told Solomon, if my people who are called by my name would humble themselves and pray and seek my face and turn from my wicked ways, then I'll hear from heaven, I'll forgive their sins, and I'll heal their land. And so if you can and will, our members and our community members, if you want and would like to join us at 12 noon for our park and pray, and about 11:30 on Wednesday, I'll come back on with another word from the Lord as our virtual Bible study. I want to tell you to keep on praying and don't lose heart in this time in which we live. Also, before I get to the message, we do have our YouTube channel that is up now. You can go on youtube.com, and in the search bar, you can type in Third Mount MT period Olive Church, and there you'll find our church logo. You click on it, and a couple of sermons have been uploaded, and so you can find us here on Facebook, and you can find and tune into our worship via YouTube. And so I want to get that out to our listening audience on today. Join me in a word of prayer, and we'll jump right in. Father, we thank you for this time we have to share your word today. Father, I ask as always that you'll forgive me of my sins and my shortcomings. You'll create within me a clean heart and renew within me your right spirit. Continue to purge me with your hyssop and wash me whiter than snow. It'll be then and only then that I'll be able to teach sinners and transgressors concerning your ways. Now, Father, thank you for letting us know last week that you are our help in the midst of these perilous and uncertain times. Thank you for the word you have given to me to share with your people on this week. Help us to hide your word in our hearts so we won't sin against you. And, Father, as always, I pray that you'll govern my thoughts and you'll guide my tongue. I pray that you'll let my light shine, but I pray you get the glory, because it's all about you and it's never about me. And to that end, we give your name praise, glory, and honor, for it is in Jesus' name we ask it all. Amen. I'm going to jump right into the message today, Psalms 121, and we'll read stanzas 1 through stanza 8. Psalms 121, reading from the English Standard Translation of the Bible, Psalms 121, stanza number 1 through stanza number 8, and it reads like this. I lift up my eyes to the hills. From where does my help come? My help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keepeth Israel will neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time forth and forevermore. God's word for God's people, the word of the Lord is already blessed. Verse 5, the A clause is where I want to extract our title. It says, the Lord is your keeper. And I want to title this message this morning, God our keeper. Last week we discovered he's our help. This week I want to remind us that God is our keeper. There was a song that was sung at the church where I grew up, the Pine Grove Missionary Baptist Church. As a matter of fact, as I grew older, I had the chance to also lead that song with the choir. And that song says, all of my help comes from the Lord. All of my help comes from the Lord. Whenever I need him, he's right by my side. All of my help comes from the Lord. And then there's a verse that says, Father, I stretch my hand to thee. No other help I know. If thou withdraw thyself from me, tell me where other can we go. My brothers and my sisters, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, as you listen in, I want to tell you, amidst these perilous times in which we live, God is our keeper. You ought to hit that like button. You ought to hit that heart button, because you understand and you know the reason why you've made it thus far is because the Lord has been keeping you. Not you've been keeping yourself, but the Lord has been keeping us. He is a keeper. I'm here to testify to you today out wherever you may be that God is the one who has been keeping us. I checked with my secretary on the way out because I haven't got on the Mississippi Department of Health website in the past couple of days, and I asked how many are infected now, and she replied 758 are infected and 14 deaths as of yesterday, and 95 has been reported new cases. But the truth is, I can testify, some of you can testify, that you are not one of the ones who have contracted this horrible disease. And the reason being, not because we've been shed in the house, because you and I, we've been out here and there and everywhere, but the reason why we haven't fallen sick, the reason why we haven't contracted this horrible disease, is because God has been keeping us. Hallelujah. Praise God that he is a keeper. Even when I can't keep myself, God is a keeper. Even when I put myself in harm's way, God kept me. Even when I didn't have sense enough to pray that God would keep me, he kept me anyway. The song says, oh, to be kept by God. God is our keeper. And that's all the psalmist wanted to remind the children of Israel while they were on their way to Jerusalem, that God was and is their keeper. Now, the author of this psalm is anonymous. Nobody know really who wrote it. Some would argue David wrote it, but the circumstances surrounding this psalm, we're not sure about it. We don't know, but we do know it's called a pilgrimage psalm, that while the children of Israel were on their way back to Jerusalem, no matter where they were, they would sing this song because they knew that God was their keeper. As a matter of fact, if you got a King James Bible, you'll discover the word keep is in there three times. The word preserve is in there three times. If you got the English Standard Version like I have, you'll discover that the word keep is in this Psalms five times, and it's trying to let us know that God is a keeper. Just a little background about this psalm. They would sing this song because while traveling, I discovered in my studies that the sun would beam down heavily on the people as they traveled. It would leave them parched. It would leave them thirsty. It would dehydrate some, but they still look towards the hill. They look towards the city of Jerusalem because they understood that God was their help. No matter what they faced on the journey, no matter what befell them on their journey, they understood that God was powerful enough to keep them while they were journeying towards Jerusalem. My brothers and sisters, you know, like I know, this life is a journey. This life is a pilgrimage that we own. And you know, like I know, while traveling on this journey called life, we are faced with so much problems. We are faced with so much trials, tribulation, and turmoil. We are faced sometimes, my brothers and sisters, in the midst of this crisis that we're in, we're faced with uncertain time. But the good news is, even though the time is uncertain, our God is certain, and he's able to keep us. Look, if you will, he opens by saying, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hill from which cometh my help. Verse 2 says, my help comes from the Lord who made the heavens and the earth. First of all, if you're taking notes, he perceived who his help was. That word perceive, when it's used with an object, it means he envisioned his help. He understood who his help was. And he says, the Lord is my help. In verse number 5, he says, I will lift up mine eyes to the hill. Now, some scholars would argue that they were actually looking to the hills for their help. But I want to counter that argument. You know, like I know, as I forestated, Jerusalem was in and situated on a hill, and it was surrounded by mountains. And what the psalmist was saying, when I look in the direction of Jerusalem, when I look into the direction of the temple, I know that God is my help. He says, that's why I will lift up my eyes to the hills. Listen, my brothers and sisters, that's what we need to do today. We don't need to look around, because when we look around, there's trouble over here, trouble over there. Look in front of us, there's trouble. Look behind us at the trouble we have overcome. We don't need to look around, but we need to look up. When we look up, that's where our help is. When we look to God, when we look to the one who had enough power to create the heavens and the earth. He says, my help comes from the Lord. This word Lord is Adonai. In the Hebrew, Adonai was a name they used because they felt that Jehovah Yahweh was too sacred for them to utter. They felt Yahweh was too sacred to utter, so they used the word Adonai. Adonai means he's our great master. He's one with total authority. And he says, I look to the one with total authority for my help. He created the world out of nothing. He put spinning worlds into existence, and they are spinning on nothing. This is the God that the psalmist says, I'm going to look to for my help. That's what we need to do. In these uncertain times, we need to look to God for our help. He perceived who his help was. He did not say, mama is my help, daddy is my help, sister, brother, aunt, uncle, cousin, relative, husband, or wife is my help. He says, the Lord is my help. He did not even consider himself as to be help to himself, but he says, the Lord is my help. He says, I'm going to look up to him. And that's what some of us need to do. We need to look up. Instead of looking around, we need to look up, because our help comes from the Lord who made heaven and earth. Not only he perceived who his help was, but secondly, he discloses to us that he's protected by his help. Look at verse 3 down to verse number 6. And in this, he says, he will not let your foot be moved. Stop right there, because since he's protected by his help, first thing he wants to let us know that we have stability. We are stable in life because God is our help. In the midst of unstable times, it's good to know that our help is able to keep us stable. Now, this letting your foot won't be moved has to deal with putting your foot on a firm foundation. Listen, life is uncertain. That's why you can't build on life's sinking sand, but you ought to build your hope on things that are eternal. You ought to build your hope on the word of God. And when your foot is fixed on a firm foundation, you'll learn in life you are stable. Why everybody else is wavering, why everybody else is unbalanced and imbalanced, you'll discover that God will keep us stable. The Bible says he will not let our foot be moved. That's not all. If you keep reading the text, it says, behold, he that keeps you will not slumber. Then he says, behold, he that keepeth Israel neither slumber nor sleep. That's good news. That's good news, because since he's protected, that means that he's stable. Then also that means that his protector is sensible to what's going on in his life. That word sensible means to be keenly aware. Notice he said he neither slumber, lightly doze, or sleep, to go unconscious, to go in a coma, to go unaware of what's going on. I'm so glad that I serve a God that neither slumber nor sleep. It means that he is aware, he is alert to what's going on in my life and in your life. He's alert to what's going on in this world pandemic in which we face. This caught us by surprise, but it did not catch him by surprise, because sometimes God allowed things by his permissive will to help us fulfill his perfect will. And this was allowed, this pandemic was allowed by his permissive will to help us fulfill his perfect will. And that means he's keenly aware of what's going on. That's good news. The president may not know what's going on. Medical professionals may not know what's going on. I heard a doctor on Thursday night, I believe, that said that they are trying to find chemicals to defeat this virus. They are unaware of what chemicals to use to defeat this virus. But I'm glad I serve a God. He's aware. He's keenly aware of what's going on. Because he's my protector, I'm stable. I can be stable in the midst of unstable time. Because he's my protector, it means he's sensible. He understands. He's aware. He's alert to what's going on in my situation. But keep on reading the text, because he says, the Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. Since he's my protector, not only am I stable, not only is he sensible to my circumstance, but there's another thing I want to share with you. We are secure because he is our keeper. Watch what he says again. He says, the Lord is your keeper. Now, I like this word keeper because the word keeper or preserve has the same meaning in the Hebrew language. We have two different words. We got keep and preserve, but in the Hebrew, it's the same exact word. And what he's trying to let us know, the reason why the word keep and preserve or keep, depending on the translation you have, is in there multiple times, because he's trying to let us know, since God is our protector, he's able to keep us secure. He is our security. Listen, I'm watching the show by the name of This Is Us, and I watched the show, and on this show, Randall, who is adopted by the family, had a burglar to break into his house. And after the burglar broke into his house, the next day he had a security system installed to alert him when someone else tries to come in his house unannounced. But just as Randall got a security system, here's the thing about Randall's security system on that show. At some point, that security system is going to need some more battery. At some point, that security system is going to need to be updated. At some point, that security system may have a mechanical malfunction. But the security system that I have, God himself, he don't need updating, because the Bible says he's the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. He will never have a mechanical misfunction or malfunction, because listen, he's perfect in all of his ways. Listen, my God, he is a keeper. Our security system may fail us here on earth, but our heavenly security system will not fail us. God will not fail us. Look what he says. The Lord is your shade. It's the same as the psalmist says, he that abide under the shadow of the Almighty shall rest. He's our shade. He's our protector. He keeps us protected. Listen, he says he's the shade at our right hand. He says the sun shall not strike us by day. I forestated in this sermon that the sun rays would beam down on them. But look what the psalmist says. He said the sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. While traveling by night, wolves could come and overtake you. Beast could come and overtake you. But look what he says. Even in the nighttime, God is our security. He's able to keep us secure. But I got to close this down, because my soul have got happy. But listen, he perceived who his help is. He says, the Lord is my help. He understood that he need to look towards the temple, towards Jerusalem, that city that sits on a hill, because God, he promised that he would be at that temple. So he says, my help comes from the Lord. He perceived who his help was. He says, I'm protected by my help. But he closes by saying, I'm preserved by my help. That's good news. Because watch verse 7 and verse number 8. He says, the Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep your going out and your coming in from this time and even forevermore. That's good news, because he said the Lord will keep you. He will safeguard you. He will preserve you from not some evil. He says from all evil. That's good news for me. Because I can protect myself from some evils, but I can't protect myself from all evil. You may can protect yourself from some evil, but you can't protect yourself from all evil. And the good news is that our keeper, God himself, Adonai, the powerful one, the one with total authority, he's able to keep us from all evil. No matter what the devil may try to throw our way, he's able to keep us from all evil. I like that, because Satan comes at us at all type of ways, but God is able to keep us from all evil. Not only is he able to keep us from all evil, but he says he will safeguard your life. Watch this. He says he will keep you from your going out and your coming in. What the psalmist is saying, when I leave the house to make my way to Jerusalem, he's able to protect me while I'm making my way back from Jerusalem to the house. He's able to protect me. Listen, I'm here to tell you, he's able to protect you wherever you may go. God is there to protect you. There is not a place on this earth that he is not there, because the psalmist says in Psalm 139, where can I go that you are not there? He says, if I make my bed in Hades, he says, you are there. He said, if I take wings and fly to the uttermost part of the earth, you will be there. That's good news, my brothers and sisters, because that lets me know no matter where I go, no matter where I am, God is there. And he, if he's there, that means his protection is there. If he's there, that means his provision is there. If he's there, that means his power is there. He's able to preserve my life. I can't preserve my own life, but he's able to preserve my life. No wonder Jude, the half-brother of our Lord Jesus Christ, says, now unto him who's able to keep us from falling, from stumbling, and to present us faultless before the presence of his glory with great joy. Thank God that he's able to keep us. Thank God he's a keeper. And I like what Jesus said as I leave you. Jesus said in John chapter 17, all that the Father has given unto me, he said, I kept, except the son of perdition. Thank God that he's a keeper. Even when I can't keep myself, he's able to keep me. Even in the midst of this pandemic that I'm facing and we are facing, he's been keeping my mind. The truth is, sometimes I've got scared, sometimes I became fearful, but then my faith kicked in and reminded me that he is a keeper. He's a keeper because he have power to keep us. How you know he have power to keep us? Because one Friday on a hill called Calvary, y'all know what he did. If y'all was in here with me, I'll tell you, he died, my brothers and sisters. According to Mark 15:25, they crucified him, my brothers and sisters, at 9 a.m. He hung out there on the cross, 3 hours in the light, 3 hours in the dark. But at 3 p.m., y'all know what he did. He laid his head in the locks of his shoulder. Y'all know what he did. He died for your sins and mine. But he didn't stay dead, because they placed him in a borrowed tomb. And early that third day morning, he rose with all power in his hand, and he made his victory speech. He says, grave, where's your victory? Death, where's your sting? He said, all power, heaven and earth, is in my hand. I want to let you know that, listen, God is our keeper. Yes, he is. He's our keeper. I didn't do this last week, but I want to do this. Listen, if you don't have God in your life, if you're listening to me and you're an unbeliever, listen, I offer my keeper to you. I offer Jesus Christ unto you today. Listen, I hear you saying, well, how can I let you know that I made a public confession? Listen, here's what you can do. Pray this prayer for me. Say, Lord, I confess my sin to you. I admit that I'm a sinner, and I want to accept you into my life. You can mean that prayer from your heart, and Jesus will come in. And here's what you do. When we open back up for corporate worship, come. And when I open the doors of the church, you walk down the aisle, give me your hand, and give God your heart, and let us know what you did on this 29th day of March. Listen, he can save you right where you are. You don't have to be in this building where I am. Right where you are, he's able to save you. Listen, if you've been fearful in these uncertain times, listen, I'm going to pray for you. because I want to let you know that not only God is our help, but God is our keeper. That's why we made it thus far, because he has been keeping us, not because we made all the right decisions, but because he has been keeping us. Every eye closed, every head bowed. Father, thank you for your word today. Thank you for reminding us that you are our keeper. We don't have to stay up at night and worry and wonder, because your word just reminded us that you neither slumber nor sleep. We can go to bed at night because you're always up. You are attentive, you are alert, you are keenly aware of what's going on with us. Father, many of us during these times are fearful and we're concerned about what's going on. But thank you for reminding us you are our keeper. I pray for the unbeliever who may be listening or will listen to this message today, that they will accept you and your finished work at the cross and your rising from the dead. Accept that work and they shall be saved. And when we reconvene corporately here for worship, that they would come and let us know the decision that they made. Father, as we go through the remainder of this week, let this word remind us when we become fearful, when we hear the reports of the medical professional, of the president, of governors, of mayor, when we hear those reports, help us to be reminded that you are our keeper. We love you so much. We praise you in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you. As I sign off, remember Wednesday at 12 noon, we will have our park and pray. Remember Wednesday at 11:30, I will come on from my personal Facebook page and will give us a virtual Bible study. And members, don't forget, at 11, started at 11 this morning to 12 noon today, we are still doing our drive-by giving. We still have to honor our obligations until the kingdom of God and to our church. Thank you so much for listening to me. And remember, as I sign off, God is our keeper. God bless you, and God keep you is my prayer.